Let us start atomic structure. In atomic structure, we are seeing about black body radiation. Black body radiation. Now, we will take a black body which emit radiation, that we will consider. Which emit radiation. Which emit radiation. Now this radiation is having what are the wavelengths? What are the wavelengths present in this radiation? That we want to know it. For which we'll pass the radiation through the prism. We'll take a spectrum. The spectrum gives what are the wavelengths present in this radiation. Sir. So we are passing this radiation into the prism. We are passing this radiation into the prism. This radiation goes for dispersion. Goes for dispersion. And the emergent radiation, this is called emergent radiation. Emergent radiation is focused over a photographic plate. The photographic plate on developing gives spectrum. So we are getting a spectrum. In the spectrum, we will have like this spectral lines. Now, this spectral line indicates some radiation fell over here, so that we got this spectral line. This spectral line will have some wavelength, will have some wavelength. Similarly, this spectral line will have some wavelength. Using this, we can find what are the wavelengths present in this radiation. Okay, now see. We have taken this radiation. This radiation is having what are the wavelengths we want to know it. For which we are passing this radiation into this prism. This radiation is undergoing dispersion and coming out. The emergent radiation falling on the photographic plate. If radiation falling on this place, at this place striking will be there in the photographic plate. If radiation falling here, at this place striking will be there in the photographic plate. Suppose if radiation is not falling here, if at this place no radiation is falling, while at that place no striking will be there. Correct? At this place, suppose no radiation is falling, then this place will be plain, where there is no striking point, there is no strain, or there is no any indication at this point. Okay, so at which points radiation falling over the photographic plate, at those points striking will be there. At remaining places striking will not be there. Okay, suppose at this place spectral line is there, at this place line is there, some striking is there, that means radiation fell over here. So this place is having some wavelength. That means this spectrum, in the sense it is just like a graph. Just like a graph. Graph paper, we will draw a graph. No. How x-axis, y-axis will be there. In x-axis some parameter will write. In y-axis some parameter will write. Like this, in this spectrum. At each place, at this place, it is just like a graph paper. Here some wavelength value will be there. At this place some wavelength value will be there. At this place some wavelength value will be there. At this place some wavelength value will be there. Okay. So here in this spectrum, your striking point is there. That means a line is present. That means radiation fell over here. So radiation which has wavelength this much, that will fall here. Okay. The radiation which has so and so wavelength, that will fall here. Okay. Now at this place, this wavelength will take. Here no striking point, no striking point, no spectral line, nothing is there. That means here radiation has not fell here. Radiation has not fell here. That means radiation is not having this wavelength. So and so wavelength radiation is not here. So and so wavelength radiation is not here, isn't it? So that what are the wavelengths present here corresponding to these wavelengths striking will be present. What are the wavelengths not present here? Those places will be plain, no striking point. Okay, so using this spectrum, can we get an idea about or can we find what are the wavelengths present in this radiation? Can we find it? Now, here we are taking black body. This black body is emitting radiation we are considering. Even we can consider black body absorbing radiation also we can consider. Anyone we will consider it. This radiation is having what are the wavelengths? What are the wavelengths present in this radiation? That we want to know it. For which we are passing this radiation through the prism. This radiation undergoes a dispersion. Here it is emergent rays. Emergent rays falling over the photographic plate. We are developing the photographic plate. We are getting spectrum like this. It is called spectrum. The developed photographic image is called spectrum. Sir. Now, at this place, striking is there. This in this photographic plate, at this place, striking is there. Striking is there means this radiation. From this radiation is falling over here now. So which radiation will fall over here? The radiation which has wavelength equal to this much, that radiation will fall over here. The radiation which has wavelength this much, that will fall over here. Correct? Similarly, here striking point is there. Striking point is there means which radiation will fall here? There in this one, the radiation which has wavelength equal to this much, that will fall over here. Isn't it? Likewise, sir, here this wavelength will take. At this wavelength, no striking point is there. That means the radiation which has so and so wavelength is not present here. Okay. Then this wavelength radiation is not present in this one. Therefore, this place, there is no striking point. It is just like a photographic plate, plane will be there. So here striking point is there means radiation has fallen here. So in this one, some radiation is having wavelength this. The radiation which has so and so wavelength is falling here, isn't it? So that from this spectrum, what we can get about this radiation from this spectrum, what do you say? Which wave characteristic we can get from this spectrum? Okay, using this radiation, you are taking this radiation and you are taking corresponding spectrum. You are taking this radiation passing through the prism and you are developing the spectrum. Using this spectrum, by seeing this spectrum, what data you can say about this radiation? What data we can say? Sir. Now we will see. Suppose we are taking a graph. The graph is like this given. Here, number of students given. Here, we will write marks. In the science test, we will write. Okay, the graph we are getting like this. The graph is like this. Marks will write some 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. Like this will write marks. Number of students will write 10, 20, 30, 40. Like this will write. Now see, using this graph, can you say the maximum number of students? Which mark is got by maximum number of students? Can we say? Sir, certain mark is possessed by how many students? Can we say? Suppose marks is 40. 40 marks is obtained by how many students? Can we say or not? You see, 40 marks is obtained by how many students? Can we say or not? You see, which mark is obtained by maximum number of students? Can we say which mark is obtained by maximum number of students? 80 marks is obtained by how many students? So using this graph, we can compare marks and number of students. From this we can say a mode, we can say median, we can say average, we can say average marks. These and all we can say using this graph. Like that, what is spectrum? Spectrum is nothing but a graphical photograph. Spectrum, what is meant by spectrum? Means spectrum is called a graphical photograph. For example, rainbow is one of the natural spectrum. Rainbow in the sky, we are seeing rainbow. That rainbow is a natural spectrum. So this spectrum is called a graphical photographic plate. So graph, spectrum is nothing but just like a graph. So graph, in the sense, some measurable terms will be there, measurable values will be there. How in the graph we are saying here marks, here number of students, here we are saying. Like this, in the spectrum also, it is just like a graphical photographic plate, in the sense, some measurable term will be there. Here we are saying marks, we are saying no here. Like this, here measurable term will be there. What is the measurable term present in the graphical paper of spectrum? Graphical paper of this photographic plate, that is wavelength. Wavelength will be there. In the photographic plate, wavelength will be there. That means at this place, wavelength is suppose lambda 1. At this place, wavelength is lambda 2. At this place, wavelength is lambda 3. At this place, wavelength is lambda 4. Like this, values will be there in the graphical photographic plate. Values will be there. Sir, this photographic plate is a photographic plate will be pure white. This photographic plate will be pure white. Sir, in the one side of photographic plate will have wavelength values will be there. Now this radiation we are taking, this radiation will have wavelength. This radiation is having wave characteristics. Wave characteristics means this radiation is having wavelength, this radiation is having frequency, this radiation is having wave number, and so on. So this radiation contains what wavelength or what wavelengths? Is it having one wavelength or is it having many wavelengths? How to know it? Okay. Only one wavelength means that light is called a monochromatic light. Only one wavelength means that light is called a monochromatic light. We are taking visible light. Let us take a visible light. This visible light, if you take visible in the sense Vibgr, this is Vibgr. Vibgr is there. This Vibgr, how it will be there? How the wavelength will be there for Vibgr? That we will see. Now, first we will take violet. Violet in the sense, this violet will have what wavelength? This violet will have one wavelength or many wavelengths? How to know it? This violet we are taking. This violet is having one wavelength or many wavelengths. How to know it? Now, this violet means suppose from ear to ear is violet. That means it will have some wavelength. It will have some wavelength. And one wavelength, that is incorrect. You are saying one wavelength. One wavelength is incorrect, sir. So whether one wavelength is incorrect or wrong, how do we know that one wavelength? How do you say that one wavelength is incorrect? In the wavelength, how do you say that less wavelength, more wavelength, like that and all? We cannot say, sir. That means we will say the first. We will come to know it. One wavelength or two wavelengths like this. That clarity we will get it first. Now we will take a sodium vapor lamp. Sodium vapor lamp we will take. This sodium vapor lamp is emitting radiation. You are switching on sodium vapor lamp, so sodium vapor lamp is glowing. It is glowing in the sense it is emitting light. It is emitting what light? Means yellow color. It is emitting light that has yellow color. The sodium vapor lamp is emitting yellow color. It is emitting light that has yellow color. Now, this yellow color is having what wavelength? Is it having single wavelength or many wavelengths? That we'll see. Now, this yellow color is passed into, this radiation is passed through the prism. This radiation is passed through the prism. This radiation undergoes a dispersion. This radiation undergoes dispersion. Sir. So, we are saying that this radiation is undergoing dispersion. Due to that, emergent rays comes. Here, emergent rays are coming. The emergent rays is focused over photographic plate. The emergent rays is focused over photographic plate. Sir, the emergent rays are striking the photographic plate. Sorry. This photographic plate is developed. The developed image is called a spectrum. It is nothing but a spectrum is nothing but just like photo. In photo, we will see our image, we will see. That is called photo, we are saying. Okay. If you see the light image, that is called a spectrum. That's all. Sir. So the developed image, the developed photographic plate is called a spectrum. In this developed photographic plate, how it is there means at one place, yellow color is there. And this yellow color is present on this spectrum. It is just like a graphical paper. So here wavelength values will be engraved. Therefore, this yellow color line is present in what wavelength? That we can say using this spectrum. Okay, that wavelength we are saying. Okay, wavelength is this much. Sir. And we are observing the spectrum. It is showing that another yellow line is there. That wavelength we are saying by seeing the spectrum. Over the spectrum, it is just like a graphical paper. No, so wavelength values will be there. So we are seeing that it comes out to be so and so. Remaining places. How the remaining places are there? The remaining places is appearing dark. This place and all dark. This place yellow color line is there. Yellow color we can see. That yellow color line present at 5890 angstrom. This place and all dark. Here yellow color line is there. This yellow color line is present at 5896 angstrom. Here and all dark. Like this is there. Now say, we are saying sodium vapor lamp is monochromatic light. That means one wavelength only, no? Isn't it? But what happens? See, it is sodium vapor lamp. It is emitting yellow color. It is monochromatic light. Monochromatic light in the sense that will emit, that will have one wavelength. But what, how it is showing? See, this yellow color light is passed through prism, and then passed through prism, and then it is going for dispersion, and the emergent ray is coming, that is striking on the photographic plate. That photographic plate is developed, that is showing like this. That means, so that at this place, suppose this place is 5890 angstrom, and this place is 5896 angstrom. Okay, so this place, at this place yellow color line is there, means radiation is falling at this place, therefore only we are getting yellow color line we can see. So this radiation comes from here like this. It is, this radiation is dispersing in this way, and the emergent rays striking at this place. Next, at 5896 angstrom yellow color line is there. At 5896 angstrom yellow color line is there, means yellow radiation is falling here. The yellow radiation which is having wavelength 5896 angstrom is falling at this place. So the radiation which has wavelength 5896 angstrom is falling here, therefore we can see yellow color here. So it is coming from where? It is coming from this radiation. It is coming from this radiation. So this radiation undergoes a dispersion. Undergoes a dispersion. That dispersion, the dispersed lines, that means how many wavelengths are there? Means two wavelengths are there. So that we are getting two rays like this. We are getting two rays. One is having wavelength this much, another one is having wavelength this much. Angle of deviation. One is having angle of deviation this much, another one is having angle of deviation this much. So you see that we got here this spectrum. In this spectrum, at this place, yellow color is there. This yellow color present at this wavelength, and at this place yellow color is there. This yellow color is having so and so wavelength. The remaining place is dark. Okay, this is dark, this is dark, this is dark. So this is nothing but this photographic plate. At 5890 angstrom yellow color line is there, means in this photographic plate only this. So at this 5890 angstrom yellow color radiation is striking. Okay, from this yellow color radiation is striking at 5890 angstrom, so that we can see yellow color line at 5890 angstrom. Now this radiation is having wavelength 5890 angstrom, so that this radiation is striking this place. Then this radiation is having wavelength 5896 angstrom, so that this radiation is striking this place. Now this 5890 angstrom is present here. 5896 angstrom also present here. Both that means 5890 present here, 5896 present here. The two wavelengths got split in this place, got split here. The two wavelengths present here has split into different here using this spectrum. So this spectrum splits the two wavelengths like this. That means the two wavelengths undergo dispersion to different angles. 5896 goes for lesser extent of deviation. 5890 goes for higher extent of deviation. Sorry. This place dark. So here dark. Here dark in the sense, here dark is there means, what is the meaning of that? You see, here dark is there. Here dark is there means no radiation has fallen here. That is the meaning, no? No radiation has fallen here. That's why dark. This place is dark, no radiation has fallen. That means so and so wavelength. So and so wavelength radiation is not there. Is not there yet. This place is dark. That means no radiation has fallen here. That means so and so wavelength is not present here. So, using the spectrum, what we can say about radiation? That is the question. Now see, we are taking black body. That black body emit radiation. This radiation is passed through prism. We are getting a photographic plate. We are developing this photographic plate. We are getting spectrum. Now, using this spectrum, what data about this radiation we can say? Using this spectrum, what data about this radiation we can say? What do you say about this? By seeing the spectrum, what data about the radiation we can say? Can you say about wavelengths? What are the wavelengths present? Or can we say what are the frequencies present? Or can we say what are the wave numbers present? Or we cannot say anything about it. Just we can say what color is present. That's all. That we can say. But what you have understood. Sir, that means you have not understood. You have not understood anything. Sorry. Now, we'll take a white light. We'll take white light. We'll take white light. This white light contains rays. White light we are considering. This radiation, this white light radiation coming like this. This white light radiation coming like this. Sir. Here let us keep a slit. We will keep a slit. What is the slit in the sense? It is just like a slit means it is just like a layer. It is just like a sheet. In the sheet at one place, a tiny hole will be there. This is slit in the sense it is just like a sheet. In this sheet, at one place, tiny hole will be there. Through this tiny hole, the radiation comes. Now, radiation comes out through the tiny hole. This radiation is allowed to fall on prism. 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 Now, what will happen, do you say? This radiation is allowed to fall on prism. What will happen? Sorry. So, you are saying that 7 band of colors are formed. You are saying that 7 band of colors are formed, you are saying. Okay. It is passed through the prism. Now, it is undergoing dispersion. Here, emergent rays coming. That emergent rays is allowed to fall on photographic plate. The photographic plate is developed. We are getting a spectrum. The photographic plate is developed. We are getting spectrum. In the spectrum, we are able to see the spectral lines. Okay. First, here what is there means violet is there. Here what is there means violet is there. So violet is there means what is the wavelength of violet? That we'll see. At this place wavelength is lambda 1. At this place wavelength is lambda 2. At this place wavelength is lambda 3. At this place wavelength is lambda 4 and so on. That means we cannot say that violet is having only 4 wavelengths. Okay. It is a range of wavelengths. It is a range of wavelengths. Now, at this wavelength, so here we can see violet color. That means this violet radiation is having wavelength lambda 1. Here we can see violet color. This violet color is having wavelength lambda 2. This violet radiation is having wavelength lambda 2. Then we can see violet color here. This violet color radiation is having wavelength lambda 3. Here we can see the violet color. This violet color radiation is having wavelength lambda 4. Now you say, if you take violet color, in the violet color, only one wavelength possible or range of wavelengths possible. Violet color is having only one wavelength or range of wavelengths. What do you say? Violet color, if you take, violet color is having one wavelength or range of wavelengths. Violet color is having, you are saying that violet color is having range of wavelengths. Here we mentioned lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, lambda 4. It is not indicating that violet color means only 4 wavelengths. Like this we should not say. It is a range of wavelengths. Okay. Sir, in the spectrum if you see, from this place to this place, violet color will be there. Sir. Next we will see here. Up to this, suppose indigo. Indigo also, shall we say, here some wavelength. It is a range of wavelength, shall we say? Here wavelength is lambda 1, here wavelength is lambda 2, like this we will say. In the same manner, this vibes are blue, green, yellow, orange, red, like this. So, now, by seeing this spectrum, what are the wavelengths present in this white light? Can we say or we cannot say? Now the question is, see this question. You are taking this white light. You are passing this white light through the slit. Through this hole radiation comes. The radiation is fallen over prism. Then it is undergoing dispersion and the emergent rays is focused over photographic plate. It is developed, we got spectrum. By seeing this spectrum, can we say, what are the wavelengths present in this white light? Can we say or we cannot say? White light has a, sir, you are saying that this white light has a infinity wavelengths. Sir, infinity wavelengths are there. Okay. Now you say, we are taking a black body. This black body is an ideal body. It is a perfect emitter as well as perfect observer. It is emitting radiation. This radiation is focused over photographic plate, passing through prism. We are developing a spectrum. Now you say that this black body radiation spectrum reveals what are the wavelengths present in this emitted radiation. Can we say or cannot reveal? Can it reveal so and so by? Or it can't? Now see that you are taking this black body. We cannot say, you are saying. Sir. Okay, let it be. You are taking black body. Can it emit radiation or not? That you say. Black body you are taking. Can it emit radiation or not? Sir, you are saying that we can say, you are saying. Okay. You are taking black body. This, it is emitting radiation. Okay. This radiation, we can pass through prism and we can develop a photographic plate and we can get a spectrum. Yes or no? We can get a spectrum. Okay. We are observing the spectrum. In the spectrum, where and all spectral lines present? That can we say or not? Oh, your one student said that What are the wavelengths present in this radiation? We cannot say by seeing this spectrum. You may be having a thought that only visible region we can see by naked eye, remaining we cannot see. You may be having that idea. That idea also you might have. Sir. So visible region means we can see that colors we can see. Other than visible region means how to see the color? The color will not be there, no. Other than visible region means color will not be there. But striking point will be there, no. Striking will be there, no. Isn't it? Striking will be there or not? Suppose this is the photographic plate. No radiation has struck on this photographic plate. That means you can see that film roll is there. In the photo industry, film roll will be there. In the camera, film roll will be fixed and the photo will be taken. Film roll, we should not expose the film roll to the light before taking the photo, isn't it? In the film roll we are placing in the camera, that film roll we should not take out before taking the photo. After taking the photos and the film roll is completed, then only we have to take out from the camera and we have to develop it, isn't it? Why we are saying that we should not take out film roll before taking photo? If you take out film roll, what happens? The surrounding has light, daytime is having light, that light is having electromagnetic radiation, that is having IR rays, that is having visible rays, that is having ultraviolet rays. Those rays strike the film roll and affect the film roll. Therefore, we should not take out a film roll from the camera before taking photo. So once the film roll is completed by taking photos, suppose film roll contains 10 photos are there, means 10 photos we have to take, then only we have to take out film roll and we have to develop it, isn't it? So in that way you think it, here this radiation is having either visible rays or IR rays or ultraviolet rays or all the rays, whatever the rays are present, let it be. That is striking the photographic plate in the sense, can we know that so and so place is striking place. So striking place is having so and so wavelength. That means so and so wavelength radiation is present in this one. In this radiation, so and so wavelength is present. Can we say or not, you think it? Okay. So in this spectrum we can see VIBGR, we can see violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red, we can see. On either side of VIBGR we cannot see the color, no, but we can see the striking place, no. Striking place will be there or not? Correct or not? If energy particle is striking here, then it will show some striking place. Sorry, you may be having another doubt also, like this. Suppose it is a photographic plate. Radiation is striking certain points. Radiation is striking certain points. These points are striken by radiation. Rest of the points are not striken.